This discussion is about the nature and characteristics of research. Research was originally derived from the French word searcher, which simply means search or seek. The prefix re, which means again, signifies the possibility of seeking the truth again on certain aspects of a problem which was studied before from a different and distinct point of view. Hence, the word research was conceptualized. Research is a systematic investigation of a certain phenomenon or series of phenomena with the use of an established method of research. Research is a systematic inquiry that utilizes a formal method of studying a problem with the ultimate goal of expanding an existing body of knowledge. Research is further defined as a scientific study or investigation conducted purposely to discover facts and significance of a condition or event with an end in view of obtaining answers to problem. Research defines a systematic, controlled, empirical, and critical investigation of hypothetical proposition about presumed relations among natural phenomena. As may logically be deduced from the definitions given by different authorities, research may comprehensively be defined as a systematic, scientific, empirical, formal, and critical investigation of relevant problems affecting realities in life. Is research beneficial to students? Research is not only beneficial to students, but also essential to life. It is undisputed that researches which are aimed to explore the recesses of knowledge would bring about changes that precede growth and development. According to what research has done on information technology and on other fields of science, may now enjoy the wonders of cellular phones and other computer softwares. In the field of teaching and learning researchers have also been coming up with educational theories and conceptual tools essential to making teaching learning effective. Strategies and techniques in teaching have been specifically drawn up to address problems conditioned by factors attributed to individual differences of learners and to individual multiple intelligences. Research will not only widen the areas of human responsibilities, but will also enhance the process of encouraging the students to convert their research experiences into a meaning-making metacognitive exercise. Research is a systematic, multifaceted human endeavor. Characteristics of a research study. As discerned from the various foregoing definitions, a research study must have the following characteristics. Number one is systematic. It is systematic, for a research study follows a series of stages that start with the identification of a problem. Number two is scientific. It is scientific, for it is based upon principles and methods of science. Number three is empirical. It is empirical, for it is based on experiences or anchored upon actual experiments. Number four, formal. It is formal, for it is designed with definite form and format. Number five is critical. It is critical, for it tends to manifest careful, precise judgments and analytical evaluation which may prompt other researchers to look into the realm of related problems. We have types of research. There are three types of research as to purpose are as follows. Number one is pure research. Number two is applied research. The last one is action research. We have pure research. This type of research aims to discover fundamental truth or principles of the unrevealed boundaries of nature for purpose of exploring new knowledge as basis for declaring new learning theory or law as in the light of the Archimedes' law of buoyancy, that a floating body displaces the amount of liquid whose weight is equal to the weight of the same floating body, or of Newton's law of motion, which upholds that a body at rest remains at rest and a body in motion will continue moving with the same velocity in a straight line unless distracted by an external force. Unlike other forms of research work, pure research is not intended to solve a problem nor harmonize a disorder. Pure research is undertaken to satisfy an intellectual curiosity. Number two is applied research. This type of research seeks to answer a problem or to settle a significant issue which provides a solution to existing difficulties. Applied research, first of all, identifies a problem in the area where the research is to be conducted. If there's a problem on the healthcare service delivery in a certain area, a research study on the problem may be conducted to find out what causes the problem so that appropriate remedies thereof should be recommended. On account of impending problem due to the rapid growth of population, a researcher may attempt to conduct a research study on the effectiveness of contraceptives for purposes of directly or indirectly discovering what solution should be offered to nip in the bud what population explosion may possibly create in terms of the economic status of the people. This process of research could be classified as applied research. A research study in the business sector, in the community, in the area of teaching, learning concerns, or in the economic, social, and emotional aspects of life are easily identified as applied research. Number three is action research. This type of research is one that calls for a study on a problem that needs an immediate action. It is generally simple in the sense that the research study covers only a particular situation at a particular place and time. Action research has the following components. Part 1, which covers introduction, statement of the problem, scope and delimitation, and definition of terms. Part 2 covers methods, findings, conclusion, and recommendation. The review of related literatures and studies may be omitted. Absenteeism in one school may be an appropriate subject for action research. Study habits of the class may also be good as a study for action research. Then, types of research as to class or category. These classes of research refer to division in a scheme of classification by level of competence and rank. Number one is training-oriented research, a form of research conducted by students in partial fulfillment of the requirements for the degree of. Number two is service research, a kind of research conducted by teachers generally in tertiary level of education as an integral part of their professional services in higher education in line with their fields of concentration. Number three is institutional research, a type of research conducted by the research office of any higher education institution in confluence with vision and mission. Number four, commission research, a form of research conducted by professional researchers on commission basis for the prime purpose of solving a problem that calls for an immediate solution. The desired characteristics of a researcher. We have four desirable characteristics of a researcher. Number one is intellectual curiosity. Does he possess an ardent desire to find out what affects one's success or failure? Number two is prudence. Is he prudent or patient in pursuing the study on the basis of available data? Number three is healthy criticism. Does he understand or accept sound suggestion and constructive criticism? Intellectual honesty. Is he capable of gaining honest reflection and fair judgment? Guidelines on assessing a problem. Number one is novelty of the problem. Is the problem new, unusual, or striking? It is spectacular in the sense that if solved, it would be of great benefit to many. Number two is capability of the researcher. Is the researcher intellectually and physically capable of completing the study? Number three is usefulness of the study. Is the study useful? Is it beneficial to a great number of people? Availability of data and information. Number 4. Are the materials or sources of data available? Number 5. Cost and time limit of the research work. Is it doable within the time limit of the research study? Can the student afford it? Then we have the problem. In research, what is a problem? A problem is precisely a question that needs an answer or solution. One who contemplates to work on a research study must first of all be able to identify a specific problem. Hence, the study on the stages of research process is a natural course. If to a human being, his body is in the temple of his soul, to a research study, the problem is the centerpiece of a scientific inquiry. We have the stages of research process. First stage, selecting a problem. To select an appropriate problem, the researcher must bear in mind the acronym for problem. P, propriety. Is the inquiry appropriate in terms of the needs of the respondents or significant others? Is it a pressing problem that needs immediate attention? R, relevance. Is the subject relevant to the present time, condition, and place? O, originality. Is it an original study in some respects in the area? Is it not a repetition of a study in the same span of period in the same place? B, benefits. Will the findings of the study be beneficial? Will the findings give the greatest good for the greatest number? L, legality. Is the study lawful? Will it not encroach upon the lawful rights of others? E, essentiality. Will the findings be essential to some particular fields of disciplines? M, measurability. Is the study measurable? Does it fit the essence of the usual acronym like SMART, which stands for specific, measurable, attainable, realistic, and time-bounded? Second stage, formulating the research title. In formulating the research study title, one has to take into account the following tips. What's the main focus of the problem? What are the major issues that should be included in the research study? Does the title clearly embody the major problems or issues sought to be investigated? Third stage, conceptualizing the research design and method to be utilized. In conceptualizing the research design and method to be used, the researcher must bear in mind his objectives, which may be elicited from the following questions. Do I intend to study the past condition, the present status, the future, or altogether the past, the present, and the future of the problem or issues to be resolved? If the approach tends to focus on the past, what it was? The design shall be historical in nature. With such design or research plan, what research method should I logically use? What type of documentation should I use? Fourth stage, constructing and validating the questionnaire. What questions should I contrive to bring about the answers to my problems? Should I make use of closed or open questionnaires? Closed, that is known also as closed-ended questionnaire or open-ended questionnaires. Who are my respondents? What kind of instrument should I construct so that my respondents could validly answer my questionnaires? Where and how should I conduct a dry run to validate my questionnaires? How many respondents do I need for my dry run? Fifth stage, selecting the appropriate sampling technique and administering the questionnaire. Which of the sampling techniques could be applied appropriately on my study? Will it be random or non-random? If so, what particular technique is applicable? Why? How will I select my respondents? How many respondents should I include so that my findings be scientifically authentic and valid? Have I sought the permission of proper authorities for the administration of my questionnaires? 16. Retrieval of questionnaires and collection of data. Have I retrieved the number of questionnaires as planned? Are they properly answered? Are the data properly collated and statistically sufficient to meet the requirement of my study? Seventh stage, presentation, analysis, and interpretation of the data. Should I present the data in tabular or graphic form? Are my textual analysis clear and are not susceptible to double interpretations? Are my interpretations basically logical? 8 stage, calling and summarizing the findings. Are my findings properly called? Are my findings arranged in the order as presented in my study? Are my findings decisive? 9 stage, drawing up conclusions and recommendations. Are my conclusions directly dovetailed with my findings? Are my conclusions conclusively denoting the major issues of my study? Are my recommendations conformably related to my findings? 10 stage, brushing up on the thesis format. Have I followed the appropriate mechanism and format of a thesis officially adopted by my school? Have I completed the essential parts of a thesis? Research design versus research method. Research design is the plan, scheme, or the pattern which shows the intention of the researcher, whether he wants to look into the truth of the past event, into the present status or condition or a prevailing event, or into the future standing and development of a certain issues. The design gives the motive of the researcher. If his motive is to come out with the truth of the past, he should make use of the historical pattern. If his motive is to find out the present or prevailing condition of a problem, the researcher should make use of the descriptive pattern. If the researcher's motive is to figure out what might happen to a problem in the future if variables, factors affecting an event may be controlled or not controlled, the researchers should make use of experimental pattern. Research method. The research method is the type of research procedure or method to be used in gathering the pertinent data for study, including the scheme in presenting analysis and in interpreting the same as in historical, descriptive, or experimental method. The research report requirements. Whether it is a thesis or dissertation, a term paper, or a project study, the research report requires accuracy, clarity, consistency in the presentation and textual discussion of the study. Accuracy. Accuracy demands that the study should be free from grammatical errors. The results must be based upon the actual findings and not based upon mere conjectures or presumptions. Clarity. Clarity calls for certainty that the decisions or interpretations is not vague or is not susceptible to double interpretations. Consistency. Consistency requires that the style to be used should be the same all throughout the presentation of the study. That's all. Thank you and God bless.